That you got there.
So I got an instrument. We've made it
Yeah, I
ourselves.
know. I actually helped making it. Simon made,
Yeah.
where is it? The shape.
I need a
The
sheep.
shape
Okay.
using compasses.
Yeah, so I made a sheep. So basically, I have made this, wait, show. It has a big circle.
Yeah,
So,
it's an instrument for drawing curved lines. And you made this, and I helped you cut out the plastic.
yeah, so the help, so we, so first of all, this big circle, so first of all, it could take, it's made of a big circle. This is a big circle over here. If you want to make one of these, you got to draw that big circle. You got to draw
Medium circle?
a medium circle at the same center point that's smaller than the big circle, and a really minuscule circle, which is whose center point is a point on the edge of the medium circle.
Yeah, that's where the pencil enters.
Yeah, that's the, yeah. So basically, you gotta if you want to make one of these, you gotta draw that. That shape, and gonna cut the big circle out, cut the small circle out, so there's a hole, and that's where the pencil fits in. That's where the
Okay. And then what'd you do with
yeah. What'd you
it?
do? Ooh, the medium circle's only for the purpose of when you need it. And for the purpose of making the instrument. So, yeah, it can slide in wherever you want. So basically, how can you use this instrument? First of all, so I gotta put some, yeah. Gotta put this orthogonal to a surface.
So, in other words, perpendicular at the right angle to the table. Okay.
Likewise, you gotta put the instrument orthogonal to the surface.
Yep.
Such that the pencil and the paper are colliding. The point of the pencil, right? Like this.
And then what do you do?
And this pencil has got to be orthogonal to the
Paper.
paper as well.
Yeah.
Then you roll the instrument. This is a fun thing. Roll the instrument. And the bigger the circle you draw, the more flat the curve you draw is going to be. So let me show you. The curve you're going to draw looks something like this. And this is actually the function that you're basically graphing. That's y equals the absolute value, or actually only absolute value a different way. Y equals the absolute value of sine of x. This is the function you're drawing.
Let me try it. Can you hold this?
So,
Can you hold this? Can you hold the book?
and by the way, the bigger your circle is, The flatter the curve is going to be, and also the if you imagine that the surface is not kissing, so to speak, the bottom of the big circle, but it's kissing the bottom of the medium circle,
which of course is impossible in the real world,
then you're graphing this function such that zero is basically that the function is just contacting the bottom of the circle surface at that point. If you imagine that the surface is kissing the medium circle, not the big circle.
Yeah. Can you hold this?
Okay.
You hold the book. And I'm going to...
A sketchbook. It's a sketchbook. So. Yeah, it's a little wobbly-bobbly, but... Although, this first curve is quite...
Yeah, but you're also holding the book in a curved way. Wait a second. Hold the book so that it stands up. Yeah, this is better.
It's very...
There you go.
Yep.
Well, I think if you make this maybe of cardboard, this should be like a thicker wheel.
Yeah.
It's almost a success. I made a couple more attempts here. Yeah. This looks much more like it.
Put those